Hi Aries, welcome to Higher Source Tarot for a tarot reading for all Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Thank you to all of you for your ongoing support. Every time you hit that like button, you subscribe, you hit the bell, it's doing something to that YouTube algorithm. That way people will see the readings who are searching for them, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. This is fun, so we'll keep going and keep reading together. And if you're new here, welcome. I post new readings every Friday, then again on Monday. And if you've heard my intro before, just scroll through. But if you are new here, you can always, if a reading doesn't resonate, just come back in a couple of days. You could look at other parts of your chart, or the style of reading is different every Monday. 1 week is a pick a card reading. There's a love reading. Mondays are also when I do a more in-depth Celtic cross style reading. Fridays are always a general reading. So again, you can look a couple times a week if it's not the reading for you. And if you like tarot and you like the channel, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to Higher Source Tarot. All right. What advice do you have for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus? What does Aries need to know, please, for the best and highest good of all concerned with Aries? Okay. All right, so we'll begin here with the tarot reading. Then we'll have the Angel Answers Oracle cards, too. All right, so we've got the Seven of Wands, the Page of Cups, the Nine of Swords, and the Six of Wands. You've got the Five of Cups, the Knight of Wands, Death, and the Moon. Well, I definitely think you have a new phase coming in. It may be a new love interest for some of you. If there's something that was disappointing in the past here, or something that's been something that's stressful that's brought some disappointment, I do see you moving on. I see you kind of just going forget, you know, not giving it too much time or energy. So if it was a, you know, if it was a relationship that just didn't ever take off, it doesn't feel like the energy of disappointment has to do with a terribly significant relationship. It feels more like I said, a disappointment over something that just didn't develop how you wanted it to. You have Scorpio and Pisces here. You definitely have fire, Aries, Leo, Sag. You've got water and air here too. Well, you've got a conquering spirit. I mean, this is you. You're the initiator of the zodiac. You go where other signs can't, and you're not afraid to take charge. You're not afraid to take the lead with things. Now, this could represent you in your personal life with something, but again, it could be work too. It's some area though where you're initiating and leading, and I definitely see it as beginning. You're going forward in a successful way because you have both the Six and the Seven here. But I actually even like it with Death, to be honest. It's like some kind of transformation that brings in this beautiful, confident energy. So sevens are all about victory and success and their successful conclusions. So again, even if you have a bit of a pushback here or something that doesn't go right away, I do feel like it goes through, whatever it is. If it's work-related, though, too, and it's almost like I hear herding cats. Have you ever seen that video? There's a short clip of it probably on YouTube, but it's kind of like that. If you have a lot of people that you work with that you need to corral together, because, or it could be your family too, but I do see that you having to align people. So with the Page of Cups, there's a manifestation happening here. Pages bring in new energy. They bring in optimism. And this one especially has kind of a fun, outgoing kind of energy. So it may be new opportunities to get out and be social. You may get invitations from people. If it's a new relationship, I do feel like it starts in a fun way. This can be manifesting an ex, but I don't see a lot of cards that are really strong for that. The only thing I would say with the Knight of Wands being here, it could be somebody that's kind of an in and out type of energy. But I do feel like if it's that, I don't think it's going to be somebody that lasts. I'll just give it to you straight there. I think you're better off with somebody brand new if you want it to be a long-term kind of thing. This is what I get. What feels sustainable here is it's new, but it's fun and it's easy. It's not one of those new beginnings. You know those, and maybe you've had a friend who's gone through this, and and it's constant problems right from the start, and you go, boy, it's supposed to be fun in the beginning. Like, you got this many problems, this isn't the one. I do feel like this is, it's more like the fun, enjoying each other's company, getting to know each other, going out and doing fun things. So this even could be related to that Knight of Wands energy that I talked about. If it's an ex that shows up, it maybe give you some stressful energy. This may also be in relationship to the Seven of Wands and trying to get people going in the same direction. It brings in some stress. So it could be even with plans and things. If you've got something you're trying to organize for your family and it just seems like nobody can find the right date, they can't, you know, there's all these little things that it makes it stressful for you. I do see you letting go of that. So if you're planning something, you may just pick a date for somebody. I do get that. You just pick a time, a date, and say, this is when it is. Come if you can. So this is that, I hear, come as you are. You know that song? I think it's Nirvana. This is what I feel like it results in, though, where you're having fun, and it's like, look, if you want to hang out with Aries, you need to get with the program, because they're moving forward. They're not going to stay in Five of Cups. So with the Six of Wands here, it is an energy of confidence. I do feel like you're going to get attention, especially too if it's you've got a new person here. And I do think if you have a choice between a new person and somebody who's kind of in and out, I'd for sure go with the new person and see what that's all about. Because I do feel like they give you their undivided attention. This other person feels like they use it more like an option, not like a priority. And this is like, you know, a priority. And I also feel like your whatever effort you put in with that Seven of Wands, even though this is the card that comes before it, I do feel like it's this kind of an outcome where you feel confident, you feel like things are moving forward. It also boosts your self-esteem and your ability to lead. You really see that as, hey, I know I did this, and that's okay. There's no downside to that. So with the Five of Cups here, it may be a minor disappointment, but I do feel like with the Two Cups behind you, it is you looking for solutions. You don't give up easily. You don't have a defeatist mindset. That's just not who you are. And so I feel like your set point or your baseline is to turn around and look at the Two Cups. So you may look at this briefly, but the Fives too are about mind over matter. And so I feel like your mindset is a lot of what helps you with this. So if it's other people who seem not invested, because I do get that, like you've got some people around you, whether it's family and the planning, or it's a sort of in and out energy where they're not invested, it may be slightly uncomfortable or painful, or like, I wish that was different, but I just don't see you staying in this. So with the Knight of Wands, this could represent a few things. Part of it is, I think it's your energy, of course, moving forward and making the best out of things, always looking for the positive, moving forward. If it's a work thing too, with that Seven of Wands, Six of Wands, I do see you having almost a build of momentum where you start to, everything starts to come together, and it gives you this energy like rushing forward. So it's almost like running to stand still at work. You may find you're very, very busy. If you're trying to do something new too, if you're making some kind of side gig or you've taken on some side thing, because Lord knows people are trying to get employees and throwing all kinds of bonuses, you may feel like you're kind of going from one thing to the next, and it is rather busy. Now, for others of you, this represents somebody in your life that's been in and out. I just don't think you're going to have the same attraction for their allure as you might have, because I think they probably are charming, and there's something good about them, or you wouldn't keep them around. I mean, Aries definitely has that ability to cut people off if needed, and so I do think there's some redeeming value in them, but I think if they've got competition, and again, this is how I get cross watchers mad at me, but oh well, if they have competition, I think you'll take a second look at the other person. I don't think you'll keep trying to make this work. Now, death is, you've got an interesting ending here with death and the moon. Death, of course, we embrace in the tarot. We welcome it with open arms because it's a new life. And that's why I feel like anything new for you is going to lead to something more. This is stepping over the wreckage of the past. And it's also, too, not doing things that aren't worth your time. It's not playing small. That's not why you're here. You're here to grow and expand. You are here to have these lessons along the way, but they're all about your expansion. So it's life, spiritual expansion is about, in some cases, really, it's about making new mistakes, not making the same old ones again and again. That's when we suffer. when we get into these patterns and cycles of repeatedly having the same mistake or difficult situation reenacted in our human lives. But with this, I do feel like it's a card of your higher self too, telling you to let go of some things. And some of it, like I said before, that if you're planning things, you may let go of some of the conditions, you know, like having to have every single person there. You may decide that's not worth the energy. We're going forward with or without you. So with the moon being here, it brings a new phase. And it is a phase two where everything kind of happens organically. So it, again, it may be as you let go of some of the control over things, you find things come together even better. So with that wrangling kind of energy of the Seven of Wands, you may find that you're persistent, but there may be parts of it you kind of ease up on, and it seems like it just happens to flow together. This can be, too, information coming to light. So there may be something that comes forward that sheds light on a situation, and I do feel like it helps you not only make a decision, but bring on that new life experience, the transformation that death brings in. It is, though, a card of not just the moon, but the moon mirrors the sun. So it's new beginnings. It's a new phase that offers information and direction. You know, it's also a card of balance, too. And so I feel like with that Six of Wands, that's also a card of bringing in balance and harmony. So anything that's been a bit out of sync or out of alignment comes into alignment here. That's the readings like this are fun in a way because they show reality, you know, right? They show that people around you aren't always in alignment, and that our, you know, our effort to be in alignment is all that really matters, or our focus effort is maybe not quite the right choice of words. It's not really about getting other people into alignment because they have their own free will. So you've got a golden opportunity here. So there's something new with death. I do feel like it brings in a new beginning for you. And you've got remain positive. So I like that here because you do have a couple of cards that are a little bit uncertain or even disappointment. You got big happy changes. We don't always get that one either. And you've got within the next few weeks. So things are moving forward here for you. So don't stop, they say, Aries. Good things are on the way. I love you, and I'll be back again soon.